On the left is a very simple HTML document. I've omitted a few lines just to make it simple and easy to understand for this demo that I'm going to show it to you. I'm trying to construct an object based on the HTML documents on the left and see if we can retrieve the information the chart set and everything from the object. Okay, so first thing we need to do is to give the object a name. So I'm going to call it the document. Okay, so the first property is HTML. Over here. So I'm going to start with HTML over here. Because HTML have two child, head, and the body. So we're going to construct the child, which is a head. Okay, the head itself will contain a lot of other information. I'm going to create an object for the head as well. And then after that is the body. So I'm going to create an object for the body as well. So inside the head, as you can see from the right hand side, the head have two child, meta and title, or rather two element. So we're going to start with the first one, meta. Again, I will use an object to contain all the information for meta. So the first one is chart set. Okay, it's UTF-8. Okay, the second elements in the head or second property is a title. So I'm going to use a property name called text content. It's a property name to store the title. Okay, so it's part. Oops. Space here. Part three. So that is all we have for the head. Let's see the body section. The body is only have one element, which is a property element. So it's quite straightforward. So again, I'm going to use the text content to store the hello digital class as the text for the paragraph. Oops. And that's it. That's our object to represent the HTML documents on the left. Now see how if we can retrieve any information from this object. So let's say I want to know what's the title of this HTML, which is just dash part 3, and it's stored into a property name called text content. So let's do a console log. Console log means it actually print out the result in the console. So we have we're going to use a dot notation to retrieve the value of the property called text content in the another property called title. So document dot, the first one is HTML. Okay, so we're going to come from here. The next one is head, so we go to head dot. In the head, we have two element or two property called title. So the next one should be title, and the last is actually text content. So text content. Okay. Let's save and run it. There you are. So you got the JS dash part 3, which is exactly the content, text content over here. So as you can see, if we can construct the app object from the HTML document, that means an element as a property itself, as an object in JavaScript, we can actually retrieve information for each element or property just simply using JavaScript. So next we'll look at what is DOM, or we in short called DOM, in long the full name is called Document Object Model. The Document Object Model, or DOM in short, is the data representation of the object that comprise the structure and content of a document on the web. The Document Object Model is a programming interface for web document. It represents the page so that programs written in language JavaScript can change the document structure, style, and its content. So let's see what the document object looks like. So I have a boilerplate web document here, HTML document, and I have a console open. So let's see what is DOM look like. So as I mentioned before, the document object model, the name of the entire web page is called the entire object is called document. So let's type document, and let's expand the content. As you can see, this exactly the same as what we have on the left. Okay, let's see what is the actual object look like. So we need to use a command called console.directory. So we just have to display the object of this called document, which is the representation of the whole entire HTML document. So as you can see, there are tons and tons of objects, although it looks like we only have a few in our actual HTML code, but in actual fact, in the background, there are tons of them. So on top of that, if you expand any one of them, right, for instance, if you expand the body, and you can see inside that there are nested object and value key value pair as well. So you can access any of these value of the property by using the simple dot notations that we have showed you before. So let's say you want to get the character set, which is which is over here, which is UTF-8. So what you need to do is you have to type document dot set, and you can see it return UTF-8. So or you want to know the title, maybe you wanted to find out the title, what is the title content, as you can see, which is the same as this title over here. Now it is a very cumbersome way of actually accessing all these objects. There are easier way to do so is by using the method of this object. One of them is to select the object, then how we can manipulate them much later. So in the next section, we'll look at how we can use the method to select an elements in the HTML file.